Yikes, that's a lot of words. All right, we'll start from the beginning. Collection of circles, upper half plane, all tangent to the x-axis. They're all lined up along the line. We're going to build them in layers. Layer 0 is two enormous circles that are externally tangent, still tangent to the x-axis. And to make each of the next, each of the subsequent layers, we're going to order all the circles that we built so far. And then for each pair of consecutive circles, we'll make a new circle that's tangent to the two circles and tangent to the x-axis, of course, because they all are. And then we make all the circles of each of these passes. Yikes. It's kind of hard to follow all these words, and I don't even want to think about what that means. So fortunately, they gave us a picture. They gave us a picture to go with the problem. This picture is worth a lot more than all those words. See what's going on here. These two enormous circles, those are our layer zero circles. I'm going to put zeros on them. And to build layer one, we build a circle that's tangent to both of our layer zero circles, both of these circles here, and tangent, of course, still to the x-axis. Now, to build layer two, we go through the ones that we've already built. And these three go left to right according to their points of tangency. In each pair, we build another circle, tangent to the pair and tangent to the x-axis. So there's one, tangent to these two, gives us this one as well. So that's layer two. Now for layer three, we're going to go through and do the same thing. Take these two, make a circle tangent to those. These two, make a circle tangent to those. These two, make a circle tangent to those. And these two, make a circle tangent to those. And that gives us layer three. And then layer four, of course, we'll take these two, then these two, then these two, then these two, these two, these two, these two, these two, and build eight more circles. That'll be layer four, then layer five, layer six. All right, so we understand how that's built. What do we want to do with it? Oh, boy. We want to take all these circles that we've built and then add up 1 over the square root of their radii. Yikes. All right, well, clearly we're going to have to figure out how to relate each of these circles, like how to relate this one to these two, this one to these two. Let's go ahead and focus just on that. Focus on just one step, building one more circle out of two that we already have. Well, we'll go ahead and draw a little picture here. Say these are the two circles we already have. Of course, we need our x-axis down here. And there's a little circle that we build inside it, and we care about the radii. And well, we have a bunch of tangent things, so we do the natural thing. We connect the centers of the circles, connect the centers, draw radii to points of tangency, and our target, of course, is going to be to build right angles. Build right triangles, so then we can break out the Pythagorean theorem. We'll go ahead and label some lengths. These radii are all x. We'll call these y, 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 and we'll call these z. We want to build some right triangles. Now, our natural place to do that so we can relate all these lengths, we've seen this sort of configuration a lot, and what we typically do is we draw this altitude, build a little rectangle down here so that this piece up here is y minus z. This is y plus z, and this piece right here, that's what we're going to figure out. That piece has length a. Break out the Pythagorean theorem. We have a squared is y plus z. That's our hypotenuse squared minus square of this leg over here. And that has a lot of convenient cancellation. When we square this out, we'll get a y squared and z squared that'll cancel out the y squared and z squared we get over here. And we're going to be left with the 2yz there, minus a minus 2yz. That gives us a plus 2yz. It gives us a 4yz total. So that a is 2 times the square root of yz. Go ahead and drop that in our diagram. Of course, we can do the same thing over here. Go through all the same steps, and we'll get 2 times the square root of xz. Well, if we do the same thing up here, we'll see that the length of this is 2 times the square root of xy. I'll put that down here. And now we have two expressions for the same distance. That's convenient because that gives us an equation. 2 root xy equals 2 root xz plus 2 root yz. Now, when we look back at this mess, we see that we want square root single radius in the denominator. And we've got square roots of products of radii in the numerator. Job for division. We're going to divide by the square root of xyz. We're going to divide out the 2 as well, because we don't need that anymore. And we get 1 over the square root of z equals 1 over the square root of x plus 1 over the square root of y. That's really nice. 1 over the square root of the radius here is 1 over the square root of this radius plus 1 over the square root of that radius. And now we have a way to relate this circle to these circles. In fact, when we go back to what we're looking for here, this 1 over the square root of the radius for each one, I'm going to break up this sum. We're going to think about this in terms of, well, the layer 0, layer 1, layer 2. I'm going to look at this in terms of each of these layers, because this relationship that we just found, well, right off the bat, we get a quick relationship between layer 1 and layer 0. Layer 1, 1 over the square root of this radius is equal to 1 over the square root of that radius plus 1 over the square root of that radius. So the part of that sum that comes from layer 1 is the same as the part of the sum that comes from layer 0. So part of that sum that comes from layer 0 is 1 over the square root of this radius plus 1 over the square root of that radius. So, from the part of the sum that comes from layer 0, it's 1 over the square root of the left radius plus 1 over the square root of the right radius. And we just saw that the part that comes from layer 1 is the same as what comes from layer 0. Now let's see what happens in layer 2. For layer 2, well, 1 over the square root of that radius is 1 over the square root of this plus 1 over the square root of that. And for the circles, 1 over the square root of this plus 1 over the square root of that. We count this circle twice, count layer 1 twice, and we count layer 0, we get this circle once, we get layer 0 once. This layer twice, that layer once. This layer twice, that layer once. It tells us that layer 2 is 3 times layer 0. So we get 2 of these and 1 of those. Maybe you see where this is going. We go up to layer 3, take these two circles, these two circles, these two circles, these two circles. We count this circle twice, we count this circle twice, we count this circle twice, we count each of these once. So we count layer 2 twice, we count layer 1 twice, and we count layer 0 once. Alright, so we come back here and we see that when we're building layer 3, we count layer 2 twice. That gives us 6 of layer 0. That counts layer 1 twice. That gives us 2 more. And we count layer 0 one more time. That gives us 9 layer 0. 9 times this sum here will be our contribution from layer 3. And then we move on to layer 4. And it's the same game. Each one of these circles down here in layers 1, 2, and 3 will get included twice. Once for each circle, the circle on either side. And then these two layer 0s, each of these will get included once. So layer 0, it only contributes 1 to the total sum for layer 4. So we get each of these twice. Layer 0 once, we get 2 times this, 2 times this, 2 times this, and 1 of those. I'll bet you figure out what that's going to be. That's going to come right out to 2 times 9, 18, plus 6, plus 2, plus 1. That's 27 layer 0. Starting to see these 3s pop out. And we can see what's going to happen for each subsequent layer. For layer 5, we're going to get 2 of this, 2 of this, 2 of this, 2 of this, 1 of this. And add that up. And we expect that's going to be 81, and we can see why these 3s are popping out when we look at what happens when we sum powers of 3. If we sum these powers of 3, it's a geometric series. We get 3 to the k plus 1 minus 1 over 2. So as you get when you sum this geometric series. So when we take all these powers of 3, we sum these up, and then we double it, that wipes out the 2, and then we add 1 more, that wipes out the minus 1, we get the next power of 3. Sure enough, layer 5 is going to contribute 81 of layer 0. Layer 6 is going to contribute 243 of layer 0. And these are the contributions to that sum that we want. Now, sum that we want is just adding up each one of these, so now we're just going to add up all of these. We could add up these powers of 3 real quick using this relationship. We take, this is our geometric series, 1, 3, 9, 27, 81, 243, the sum of that. Take the next power of 3, which is 729. Subtract 1, get 728. Divide by 2, you get 364. And we add on the one more, we get 365. So when we add all of these up, we add all of these up, we get 365 times the layer 0. That's 365 times this sum. I'm going to write it as 73 plus 70 over 70 times 73. I'm going to take out a factor of 5 here. Leaves me 14. Take out a factor of 5 here. And sure enough, I get, very conveniently, I get 73. So I can knock out the 73s as well. And I get 143 over 14. We go back to the problem. We find 143 over 14. We're real happy about that. And we're done.